Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, now we are going to do a new topic based on hydrogen bonding, a kind of new intermolecular force of attraction. So let us learn about it. So as mentioned on your screen, I am talking about hydrogen bonding. So let us understand what does hydrogen bonding means. It is a special kind of dipole-dipole interaction. The first thing is, it is a kind of special kind of dipole-dipole interaction. This dipole-dipole interaction, we had made a lecture on this also, in which you could see in our previous videos. So in dipole-dipole interaction, it was based on the electronegativity difference between the two atoms. That is, one was being partially positive charged and one was being partially negative charged. Similarly, hydrogen bonding is based on that concept only, that is dipole-dipole interaction. But it includes something else and something special. So what is that? Let us see. The electrostatic force of attraction between positive charged hydrogen, in this case the hydrogen is the main thing which makes the hydrogen bonding, or because of which the hydrogen bonding is been validated. So a positively charged hydrogen atom of one molecule and negatively charged atom of other molecule. Suppose if you are talking about two molecules that both are being interacted with each other, and that should contain at least, that is, among the two molecules, one molecule should consist at least one hydrogen atom, so that it could form hydrogen bonding with the other molecule. So let me give an example of that, so that it would be very much easy for you to understand. So let me give you an example for which you could understand what is hydrogen bonding and where it is being located and how it is being formed. So the first of all, the first example that I want to give you is for H2O. So this is a H2 molecule, in which we could clearly say that since we know that oxygen has a partially negative charge, so this is the one which is having a partially negative charge, while that of the hydrogen which is having a partially positive charge. So this makes this atom to be polar. Why? Because the oxygen which is present here, which is the atom which is highly electronegative, while that of the hydrogen which is highly electropositive. So this creates the large electronegativity difference between these two atoms, that is for oxygen and for hydrogen. And because of this electronegativity difference, they act like a polar molecule, and they are basically polar molecules. So now what happens? Suppose if this H2O molecule interacts with other H2O molecule which is present here, suppose in this case, so I could easily say that this hydrogen is having partially positive charge, while this oxygen is having a partially negative charge, while this hydrogen is also having a partially positive charge. So suppose these two molecules, when interact with each other, how they will interact? In this case, as we could see that this oxygen, which is a highly electronegative, it will try to attract the hydrogen atom of other molecule which is electropositive. So the both are being of oppositely charged, and the both will try to attract each other. So this kind of interaction we have already did, that is in dipole-dipole interaction. But now this is a dipole-dipole interaction, but it includes hydrogen atoms also. So therefore, this kind of interaction between a electronegative atom and a hydrogen atom of other molecule makes to give the hydrogen bonding. So this is for the H2 molecules. We could also examine this for NH3 molecules also, because in NH3 molecule, the nitrogen which is being covered with the hydrogen atoms, as you could see, this nitrogen is surrounded by hydrogen atoms, and we easily know that the nitrogen is electronegative because it is the smallest the first atom which is belonging to that group, that is nitrogen, and it is basically highly electronegative. So therefore, this is highly electronegative compared to that of the hydrogen, which is basically positive. So because they both are been bonded with each other, so one will acquire partial negative charge, while the other will acquire partial positive charge. So this makes the electronegative difference within the molecule, and hence the NH3 is a dipole or NH3 is a polar molecule, because of there are two kinds of pole where we could see that is two kind of charge, that is positive charge and negative charge. So this is basically a dipole molecule, or we could say yes, a dipole molecule, or basically a polar molecule. So let me give another example. Suppose if this ammonia is been surrounded by various ammonia, so suppose I am taking only one ammonia which is been very close to this ammonia molecule. So suppose if I would consider this one, again another molecule of ammonia, and let me tell you, this is not the actual representation of ammonia, because these are not the bond angles that I am explaining. I am just explaining the interaction between the hydrogen and the nitrogen that would take place. So this is not the geometry of the ammonia molecule. I am just giving a small example so that you could understand in a better way. So in this case, I could see that the nitrogen, which is highly electro, or which is been partially negative, because nitrogen is highly electronegative in the whole group which has been present in the nitrogen group. And talking about the hydrogen, hydrogen is having a partial positive charge when it is being bonded with the nitrogen. So what happens is now here that the nitrogen which has a partially negative charge within the molecule, while that of the other molecule which is having a partially positive charge, so this makes the difference in the electronegativities. So and the both are been oppositely charged with each other, so what happens is they forms a kind of interaction, they attract to each other, and because this is also dipole, so they will have a kind of interaction, that is this nitrogen will have interaction with the hydrogen of other ammonia molecule. So basically this is a dipole-dipole interaction that we could say. But the most importantly, and if we go and if we say very precisely, there is hydrogen atom which is present in the other molecule. So this is a dipole-dipole moment, that for sure. But the most important thing, this dipole-dipole interaction is because of the hydrogen also, which is having a partially positive charge, while that of the nitrogen which is having a partially negative charge. So this is a dipole-dipole interaction, but basically hydrogen bonding kind of interaction also. So that is what the hydrogen bonding was meant to be. So in various molecules it can show hydrogen bonding. So the most important thing is that hydrogen should be contained while interacting with the other molecule, and it should form an electronegative difference between the hydrogen molecule and the other molecule, other electronegative molecule through which they have been interacting. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood hydrogen bonding very much clearly. So share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.